My name's Richard, and I need your help. This may sound unbelievable, but an unexplainable wave of horror is sweeping through my city. The worst thing is that I somehow seem to be involved. My wife has disappeared without a trace.
Can't protect you from us forever, Richard. And who are you? Mind your own business, or else. I told you, stay out of this. Get out of here. You're going to regret this. Don't draw too much attention to yourself, Detective. Detective, I'm glad you made it. I saw you get attacked in the yard, but you dealt with them quickly. It's clear that you're tough enough to deal with this case. My wife, Rosalind, came to me a few days ago. She asked me for an eye-watering sum of money and couldn't explain what it was for. I don't have even close to that amount. I had to say no. After that, she ran out of the house in tears. I haven't seen her since. Please, Detective, find my wife.
the money, or I'll kill him.
It's not the first attack, and it won't be the last. I'm afraid my house is no longer safe. Those criminals keep coming back. They bombard my walls like crazed birds trying to catch their prey. I recognize them because I created these puppet dolls to be servants to the city. Rosalind?
I'm sorry, my love. I didn't know the price would be so high.
It's my wife. She attacked me. I've never seen her like this. When you took off her mask, the hatred in her eyes disappeared. She looked scared. She's unconscious and her pulse is weakening. She doesn't have long. We have no other choice. Do you see a curtain with a special symbol? Please, draw it up and open the door to my laboratory. There's something inside that will save my wife's life, at least for a short while. I'll explain everything later. Did you just break my... Oh, never mind. I forgot to tell you. These masks are parts of the door's unlocking mechanism. My puppet assistant was supposed to bring one of them, but something must have stopped him. Please, look around. This will help you recognize my puppet. Excellent. You found all the masks. Hurry and open the door. You did it. Please, follow me. Now, can you help me get rid of these muddy outer garments? The laboratory pod needs to remain sterile to function. This bracelet may be the cause of her strange behavior. She seemed detached lately. We were spending less and less time together. She kept shutting herself away for long periods of time. She even started to take her room key with her. I once saw her looking through her mail and taking notes in her diary. When she saw me, she screamed at me and hid the papers. Since then, she's kept it with her at all times. Yes, she must have been hiding something in the diary. Maybe it will help us understand what's happening. The diary's in her room. Her name is engraved in gold on it. Here, it'll help you to open Rosalind's room.
Detective, the noise must mean that the door security system worked. Do you see this crystal? It's the heart of the puppet mechanism. Every time you see such a crystal, you'll need my puppet assistant's help. Yes, it's him. Oh, he's broken. I have something that will help to bring him back to life. Don't look so surprised. Even the simple mechanisms in my house are capable of many things. Now hurry, you'll need to restore my assistant to get Rosalind's diary.
Thank you. You're not my dear Mistress Rosalind intruder. You may not take her personal things, especially those I protect personally, like her diary. So farewell. Don't take things that aren't yours.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to scare you. I see you've opened my wife's diary and found her correspondence. I only have a few minutes, so let's take a look. The letter is encrypted, but I recognize these symbols. They were encrypted with my own device. I would never have believed Rosalind would use my decoder typewriter against me. I wonder who made her do it. I'm afraid I must go back to the lab. My wife keeps the decoder typewriter under her bed. As soon as you decipher the letter, bring it to me. It may shed light on who's behind these terrible events and help us to save Rosalind.
Thank you.
Dear Agent 26, I plan on getting money for a cure from my husband, Richard Rives, the mayor. But how can I explain why I'm asking for so much money if we signed a non-disclosure agreement about the clinic? Sometimes it seems like you're acting like outlaws. The clinic gates are always closed, and I can only get an appointment at night. If you have a heart, I beg you, give me more time. Your bracelet already torments me with unbearable pain around the clock.
Detective, did you manage to decipher Rosalind's letter? Oh no! Rosalind is terminally ill, and I'm only finding out about it now! It turns out that she had a secret correspondence with a clinic, but this is the first time I'm hearing about such a facility. According to the letter, my wife is supposed to meet with the agent at the Central Square today. He's already waiting for her there. Take my brooch and go to the square. Talk to this mysterious Agent 26 and find out what my wife got involved in. I'll find a way to contact you later.
But doctor, I've been waiting for Rosalind for 40 minutes already. I'm not interested in your whining. I'm telling you, she'll be here any minute. If she doesn't want to come herself, the bracelet will force her to. Our victims, I mean clients, lose their willpower when our roses push their metal thorns into their skin. She's a tough one, Doctor. The bracelet had to have driven her crazy already, but she still hasn't come to the meeting. I think... I didn't hire you to think, Agent 26. Just follow my orders and wait for Rosalind. Then bring her to me. I've prepared a lovely surprise for her. One that could make her lose her head. And remember, no witnesses. What? What do you want? You're not the one I'm waiting for. Go wherever it is you're going. How do you know? Oh, Richard hired someone to find his wife. You learned about the meeting with me, which means that our non-disclosure agreement about the clinic was flagrantly violated. I'm sorry, but the doctor would be very upset if he knew someone was trying to prevent his plans. You shouldn't have left your house. Night isn't the time for taking walks. Night is the time to sleep.
Thank you.
Are you mad, Richard? You imagined medical help differently? As for you, my dear Rosalind, you'll play a key role in today's show. Lead them inside. Just when I'm almost ready to start, you say we have uninvited guests? It doesn't matter. I'm one step away from what I've prepared for all these years. Block the door. No one can get in and meddle in my plans. I'm sorry. Your beloved husband cares about you so much. I didn't mean to hurt you, but it was the only way to get to Richard. Someday I'll ask you, did you sleep well in a soft bed that night while I found myself at the bottom of that damp cave, while I was scared and alone? I was covered in blood and mud, pierced by dozens of strange crystals that were burning my skin. I was confused and started cursing my own mind. And snakes. They were everywhere. They crawled over my face and under my clothes. I wanted to throw them off, but my body wouldn't listen to me. I thought I would hate them. But I loved them. Every day they reminded me of your betrayal. You're like a snake, Richard. Cold-blooded and poisonous. You'll pay for everything.
This madman will kill us all! Let go of us! Who do you think you are?
Oh, you'll know who am I. Consider this the fulfillment of your final wish.
Walter? It can't be!
Today I'll get what I've been dreaming of all these years. Justice. If you want to live, I'll have to ask you a favor. Be a good girl and kill him.
Ah! You! And as for you, I can't have any witnesses. You'll take what you've seen to the grave.
Thank you for saving me, Detective. So the madman is Walter. I hired him as a junior assistant years ago. You see, when I met Rosalind, I no longer had time to complete the stasis pod. Maybe I asked too much of him, but I was lost in the clouds. Walter lived at my estate and worked day and night. He barely slept or ate, and then I noticed he had started looking at Rosalind. Constantly. It made me furious. When I asked Rosalind to marry me, Walter went mad and confessed his love for her. I threw him out of my house, and now he's kidnapped my wife, and I'm helpless to do anything. Please follow them.
The doctor told us not to go in, no matter what. I hope he can get out of there to give us more instructions. If anyone else comes out, we'll get rid of them.
Detective, may I have a word with you? I'm afraid I'm too wounded to go with you. I'll stay and look around the lab. Maybe I can find something we can use against Walter. You go on ahead and save my wife.
Transport puppet machine is waiting for you and the lady in the central square, just as you asked, Doctor. Yes, I wrote everything down. No, I won't mess anything up. Wait a minute. The doctor can't possibly be...
You won't get away from me this time, Doctor! The bracelet will be mine! Or my name isn't Roy Jawbreaker!
If I'd been able to get through this gate mechanism, I could have smoked the doctor out of his hiding place. They say he brought some scared-looking girl with him. I don't want to involve innocent people, but that bracelet will be mine! The doctor must be taken alive. And the girl, Prepare fuel and matches. I'll attack the lighthouse after dinner.
memories are wonderful. My wounds are healed, and now I'll be able to get rid of that madman quicker than Oh, what's this? A broken puppet. Give it to me. It seems you haven't saved my wife yet, Detective. We don't have unlimited time, you know. I'll join you soon. I just need more time. What are you waiting for? Go!
Thank you.
I won't listen to your nonsense, Walter. I can't even believe you're alive. And you must be lying. Richard would never do something like that.
I didn't want it to get this far. I shouldn't have hurt you, Rosalind. There's no time for me to repeat what I told her. Please, don't try to stop me. I must face Richard, and only one of us is coming out alive.
Gotcha!
Who are you? Why are you helping me? Richard's wedding gift. Thank you for returning it. If you really want to figure out what's going on, check Walter's notes. He left me this, but I can't understand much of it.
Thank you.
Mastering your technology was child's play, Walter. Do you hear me? If you want your revenge, come and get it. Oh, I can't wait to finish what I started 10 years ago. I will destroy you. Find me in the place where it all began. And if you don't show up, I'll tear this city apart brick by brick to find you!
Richard? No! How could he? Please find Walter. He's the only one who can stop my husband, but he needs your help. Don't worry about me. I'll be safe back at the estate.
It's no use, Detective. I'm dying. Thank you, Detective. I'm sure Richard told you his usual lies. I want you to know the story from my side of things. I started out as Richard's assistant, but soon we were working as equals. My knowledge of medicine and his technical skills allowed us to develop a working stasis technology. I considered him a teacher and a friend, but to him, I was a rival. When Richard met Rosalind and gave up on the project, I moved to his estate so I could continue our work and earn his respect. I toiled day and night. Rosalind was so kind. She saw that I was terribly exhausted and did her best to take care of me. Over time, I fell in love with her. When Richard proposed to her, I overreacted. I told him how I felt, and he threw me out. But I took all of my groundwork for stasis technology with me. To make amends, Richard invited me for an evening walk in the countryside. He said he wanted to study the ancient excavations. We stopped near the edge of a cave, and Richard called me over to look at something unique. All I remember after that is a stabbing pain in my back, a long fall into darkness. If Richard is waiting where it all began, he must mean the ancient excavations in the countryside. You should hurry before Richard starts attacking the city with his puppets. Here, this will help you get there.
well, the doctor and the detective are working together now, huh? It's no matter to me. You can both rot in this cave forever!
Richard, stop! You've gone too far. If you're so determined for people to die in this cave, then I'll be one of them.
No. Walter. Rosalind? What have I done?
Don't worry, Detective. You did your job well. But it seems the world just isn't ready for this technology.